Hey guys, welcome back. This is Bernardo from the BTNHD, and yes, PC defragmentation explain. Now, if you ask any PC tech guy how to make your computer faster, almost every tech would tell you to defrag your PC before purchasing anything. So you're probably saying to yourself, what is defrag? Now, the wiki definition of this is defragmentation is the process that reduces the amount of fragmentation. It does this by physically organizing the contents of the mass storage device used to store files into a smaller number of continuous regions. It also attempts to create larger regions of free space. Well, you really don't need to with today's modern operating systems. The reason for this is if you're using a solid state drive in your computer, you shouldn't be defragging the drive because you want to avoid excessive wear and tear on the drive. Check this out. Windows 7 and 8 is smart enough to disable defrag for solid state drives. If you're running Windows Vista, make sure to disable the automatic defrag and upgrade your current operating system. For those that are running Windows XP with solid state drive, you are crazy. Okay, so you're using Windows 7 and Windows 8 or Vista. Did you know that your system is already configured to defrag on a regular basis? Actually, it's configured to run 1 a.m. every Wednesday. You can check yourself by opening up Disk Defragmenter and checking the schedule there. There's a problem here, because if you turn off your PC every time after using it, the defrag task would never get a chance to run. I would recommend checking the defragmenter, and if it has not defragged the drive for a while, run it manually. What if you're not satisfied with Windows defrag built-in software? Well, there are some third-party defrag utilities, but unfortunately, I don't have the solid proof that they improve performance better than Windows default disk defragmenter. For what I hear, commercial defrag utilities definitely accomplish the task a little better by adding features like the boot time defrag, boot speed optimization, tools for defragging the registry, and it defrags system files a little better. So the question pops up again. So do you really need to run defrag on your machine? Over the years, the hard drives have gotten much faster at both sequential and random reads and writes. The use of defragging has dropped a lot. Modern computers these days have giant hard drives with enough space that Windows doesn't have to fragment your files in order to write them to the drive. If you're trying to get every last drop of performance out of your hard drive, then go defrag away, guys. Or you could put some cash towards a new solid state drive, which would massively increase your machine performance. And that's it, guys. PC defragging, the good and the bad, there's cons and pros. If you're running Windows 7 and Windows 8 with a standard hard drive, your machine is already doing it, but if your machine is not running 24/7, most likely the task is not running. You could always change the task or create your own custom task for the defrag to work on your schedule. Or if you have a solid state drive, do not defrag that solid state drive because it is not meant for it to be defragged. Again, guys, if you have any questions about this particular topic, leave your comments right below at the comment section. Don't forget about hitting that like button. And also there's a nice little button right there that says subscribe. Make sure you hit the subscribe button to get the latest and greatest tips and reviews on technology. And I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.